a rare moment of stillness. Most of the time, Cambodia's Bante Srei Butterfly Sanctuary is a blur of dazzling colours. Set in a lush tropical garden, it shows visitors the complete life cycle of the creatures, from tiny eggs to caterpillars to the finished article.
You know, the butterflies are not increased, they are decreased. So these are we set up these for protected, some of the endangered species or conservation, some of butterflies. And also the other idea is to create a job for the people living in the community.
The insects are bred by local villagers, who are provided with a breeding cage and taught how to recognise some of the dozens of native species. In peak season, they can earn around $150 a month. Every few days, Corn Survey searches among the plants in her garden, collecting the eggs and caterpillars she finds.
I was afraid of caterpillars and would feel sick. I would brush them away if I saw them on my shirt. But because I had no work, I decided to do this. Now I'm used to it. I'm not afraid of caterpillars anymore.
Before the caterpillars emerge as butterflies, the center's staff hang the jewel-like chrysalises in a box, where they're protected against predators and parasites. After around 2 weeks, the metamorphosis is complete, and the villagers receive a sustainable income.
Every time they bring the chrysalis in, we record how many of the chrysalis do they bring in, and how many species do they have. So at the end of the month, so we total all the chrysalis, and we pay them. So different species is going to cost different price.
Through its work, the centre hopes to encourage conservation of Cambodia's forests, which have been ravaged in recent decades by illegal logging and rapid development. It's also providing a sanctuary to some of the region's smallest, most colourful creatures.